Okay, Nirmala wants to respond. Do she has a response to that?
Especially on this donation which has been given by Dow Chemicals. One of our karyakarta definitely did collect the money. And you know how the fund collection takes place. Checks are collected, receipts are given, and after which, when the central party realized it was from Dow Chemicals, with a clear covering letter, the money was returned. And there are documents to show that. I'm glad you're picking up on documents, but I think you should get the documents incomplete where the money was returned.
Advice given by Mr. Arun Jaitley, where he says
as
Dow Chemicals cannot be treated as responsible or directly liable or indirectly or under civil or criminal proceedings for the Bhopal gas tragedy. It is exactly what Abhishek Manu Singh we said. These were the very allegations you leveled at the Congress party, which are now coming back to haunt you. The point that we're making is it seems the BJP and the Congress are both culpable.
No, absolutely not. Please hang on. I'm not trying to score a political point here, but let us not jump from one to another. You asked me a question for which I've given you an answer, and I think you should also have collection of documents. When you're questioning a party about this, there is also the other side of the story which I'm telling you, and I'll gladly share the document to you. So, Mr. Your political editor should also know that party did give the money back. It's not as if we've collected and sat over it. Receipts were given, that's gone. So that chapter closes there. As regards the political opinion, as regards the legal opinion given by a leader, those are matters which are going to come up in the court. But that doesn't absolve the party. That doesn't mean that the party cannot raise the issue at all of justice to be given to the people who suffered the attack.
Okay.
So it doesn't mean that if there is a professional advice given by a particular leader,
he's also leader of the opposition.
Let me just finish it, right? If there is a professional opinion given, and that opinion is given when he was in practice, it is to be taken at that. But as a party, if we have a position to take, we will certainly take it.
Okay.
And we will certainly talk about it. That doesn't mean that we can sit back and say, oh, somebody has given a professional advice, therefore the party cannot have a role.
I want to now shift our
focus.
That
is not hypocrisy.
To
and I think
Gordon Streep. He's a US diplomat who was in 1984 the deputy chief of mission at the American Embassy in India. We've got some quotes from him, and what he says is very interesting. He says, I was informed of Anderson's house arrest. I contacted the government of India to request intervention to secure his release in accordance with our original agreement that Anderson would not be subjected to any legal action during his visit. He then goes on to say, I immediately contacted the foreign ministry, listen carefully, and was assured that the government of India would honor its commitment to provide Anderson a safe passage in and out of India. He says the MEA made that assurance to him. I want to go across to Manish Tiwari, who came out in a press conference conducted by the Congress party earlier this afternoon and said that blaming the Rajiv Gandhi government, you said, Manish, was unfair and incorrect. And now we are seeing the then deputy chief of mission at the American embassy come out and say that the American government had struck a deal with the Indian government, led by then Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi, which said that Warren Anderson would not be arrested on his arrival. It seems the Congress has been speaking in two voices on this, Manish.
Well, I'll tell you, it is absolutely and completely erroneous, to even make this imputation, because let's not forget, who is the person that we are talking about. Here was the Prime Minister of India, who a month before that had lost his mother, who was the former Prime Minister, to the unity and integrity of this country. And 5 years later, he sacrificed his own life again for the unity and integrity of the country. And if you look at the track record of the Congress party, the Congress party did not even succumb when the Americans sent the 7th Fleet into the Bay of Bengal, when the battle for the liberation of Bangladesh was going on. So to make this kind of an imputation is absolutely incorrect. When Mr. Warren Anderson came here, there was already a FIR which was registered. He was named as an accused. It is correct that he was granted bail.
Manish, this is not the BJP saying so. This is the then deputy chief of mission at the American embassy in New Delhi saying the government of the United States had a deal. This was an understanding they'd reached into. He spoke to the MEA. The MEA assured him that Warren Anderson will be allowed to leave. That is exactly what happened.
Rahul, there's a complete contradiction between the facts as they appear and the statement which purportedly has been made. At that point in time when Mr. Warren Anderson decided to come to India, the FIR had already been registered and he had been named as an accused. And allow me to point out that along with Mr. Warren Anderson, there were other people who were granted bail and who finally subjected themselves to the process of law. You know, all of us 25 years later can say, and rightly so, possibly they did not get the punishment that they did deserve. But let us also understand that if there is somebody who has absconded from the process of law and going across nine governments over a period of 25 years, if we were not able to extradite him, you know, there is a systemic failure.